Hello, it's another week on DLI, Development, Empowerment and Leadership Initiative. And last week, I promised to move on to speak about shareholding or buying equities on the stock exchange as a means of financial preparation for retirement. Yes, that is in the bigger context of talking about how do you get ready for retirement, because if you live long enough, this is something that is inevitable. So, how can you use stocks or shares as instruments to prepare for a restful and peaceful retirement? What are shares? What are stocks? This is when you put your money to own a slice of an organization. The amount of money you have, which again, like I have been saying, if you are able to live on a budget, create savings, the bigger the pool of your savings, the bigger your opportunity to take up a substantial part of any company. And once you put your money onto the stock or the shares, as it is also commonly called, you own a bit of that organization. This, compared to the treasury bills and the money market instruments, is a bit on the risky side. Of course, you cannot lose more than the money that you have put in, but it's actually possible for you to put money into stocks or shares, and not only will you not make any returns from it, even the value of the share that you are holding may continue to depreciate, and sometimes companies that are listed could go completely bankrupt. And this is why it has a higher risk profile. Therefore, before you invest in the stock exchange, please, you need to be sure of the fundamentals of the organization in which you are investing. Like anything else in life, it goes through cycles. There may be points where the company will be flourishing and hitting the targets. There may be points where the company may have to struggle, maybe when the equipments are now getting old and then they are having to have a lot of other disruption. Sometimes government legislations could cause disruptions for the macroeconomic environment or even a small subset of the industry. But where the fundamentals of a company is sound, in the long run, you will certainly benefit. What are the returns you can expect? Your shares will deliver dividends. Dividends is the name for the profit of the company that is shared with the shareholders. Unfortunately, this is not within your control. The board and the management of the company must decide if and how much of the profit they would like to share year on year. The second benefit you can also get from owning shares is that even the price of the share may appreciate. Imagine you are buying a share at 1 naira per share, and if the company does well, the forces of demand and supply can slowly nudge it to 1.25 naira, 1.50 naira. It could go as high as 4 naira, 5 naira, 6 naira, meaning that even if you decide to sell your shareholding in that company, in addition to whatever dividend you've earned while you were a shareholder, you will still make some capital gain between the 1 naira that you bought and the 4 or 5 naira that you are selling. And like I said earlier, the reverse is also the case, where if the price falls below the 1 naira, it means that you have also suffered value losses. Therefore, it is critical that you shine your eyes and you do a thorough evaluation of companies that you want to invest in their shares. That is why share investment or equity investment is better as a long-term investment, where you give the market the opportunity to play out, and then you can buy and sell and buy and sell and buy and sell, either directly or working through your stockbrokers. But please be sure that I'm not talking about investment like MMM. or YYY or ZZZ, anything that promises you 20 times, 15 times, and you don't understand the fundamentals, you need to be wary, you need to pull your ears and run. The truth of the matter for me is always like this. If it is so easy to make money, then why would the billionaires of our world, why would they bother about the tough investment of setting up factories and setting up companies and doing the hard work of hiring people, performance management? Why would anybody need to go through all that drama? So, if it is too good to be true, most of the time, it is not. Therefore, what I'm talking about in terms of shareholding or equity is not the Ponzi schemes of this world where you are promised impossible returns in no time at all. It does not matter whether some people have made money from it. Those of you that will enter towards the end of the game are the ones that will pay for the money already made by the early entrants. Therefore, you need to be sure that I'm not talking about things like that, but I'm speaking to real companies with real businesses that you need to study, understand their fundamentals, and be ready to play for the long run, which allows you to earn dividends, allows you to earn capital gain on the purchase price, and you can exit and enter and exit and enter as many times as you want, all in the name of ensuring that you build a financial base for your retirement. As you can see, we are about 1,000 feet above sea level now, and therefore we are close to touchdown, and I'm sure you will not want to miss that. So make it late next week as we continue the conversation. Until then, T-Mark is my name, Dila is still the channel, and don't ever forget that all we are trying to do is what? Make a little difference. I hope to see you next week. Bye!